Hi, this is John. Welcome to part two of the IT Taster video, Configuring Group Policy with Windows Server 2008 R2. In the first video, we looked at what group policy does. We created some group policy objects. We configured a few policy settings and saw the results on a client workstation. Now, the next thing I want to go through is the order in which group policies are applied and the configuration options we have. It's important to understand this because otherwise you're likely to get some unexpected results. Okay, let's open up Group Policy Manager. I've created a new Help Desk Users GPO and I've linked it to our IT Taster's organizational unit. I've configured the Help Desk Users GPO so that it will allow users access to the control panel. We now have two group policy objects with settings that conflict with each other. If we edit our IT Taster User GPO and go to Policies, Administrative Templates and Control Panel, there we can see Prohibit Access to the Control Panel is enabled. If we do the same thing for Help Desk users, there we can see Prohibit Access to the Control Panel is disabled. So what setting will be applied to our end users? This brings us to the important topic of group policy precedence. We need to know the order in which group policy objects are applied and which has the highest priority. Computer workstations have their own local policies that you can set on each individual machine. These policies have the lowest priority of all and will be overwritten by our server GPO settings. In practice, though, it's best to configure and apply group policies centrally from the server. The local machine policies are applied first. These are then followed by site policies. Next comes the default domain policy, and then policies that are linked to organizational units. And then finally, policies that are linked to child organizational units. Policies work their way down, overwriting along the way. The end result is a combination of policy settings. Let's take a look and see how policies are applied in more detail and how this affects individual policy settings. Here are our two group policy objects. The first policy to be processed is a site policy. Next is the default domain policy. And finally, the GPOs we've created and linked to our organizational unit. GPOs are processed by link order. Link 2 has the lowest priority and is processed first. This also means that our help desk users GPO settings also take the lowest priority. Link 1 has the highest priority. And this means that the IT Taster's user GPO also has the highest priority because it's processed last. Last writer wins. The policy settings are then applied to the users within our organizational unit. To understand this further, we need to look at what's going on with the group policy settings inside the GPOs. In this example, we have policy 2 configured as Prohibit Access to the Control Panel Enabled. This policy has the lowest priority of the two and is applied first. Policy 1 has Prohibit Access to the Control Panel Not Defined. This is a neutral type setting and it's best to think of it as transparent. It makes no changes. Therefore, policy 2's Prohibit Access to the Control Panel Enabled wins. This example is the same scenario we have configured on our server. Policy 1, the IT Taster User GPO, has Prohibit Access to the Control Panel policy enabled. Policy 2, the Help Desk User's GPO, has Prohibit Access to the Control Panel disabled. These policies directly conflict with each other. However, Policy 2, Prohibit Access to the Control Panel disabled, is processed first and it has the lowest priority. Policy 1, Prohibit Access to the Control Panel Enabled, is processed last, therefore it has the highest priority and last writer wins. the policy setting applied, is prohibit access to the control panel enabled. Now that's pretty straightforward up to now, but unfortunately there is a configuration setting that adds a little extra complication that we need to be aware of. A whole GPO can be configured as enforced. This means the individual settings in the policy are fixed in place and cannot be changed by policies processed after it. In this example, policy 2 is processed first and the GPO is enforced. Prohibit access to the control panel setting is disabled. Policy 1 is processed last. Prohibit access to the control panel is enabled, but because policy 2 is enforced, even though policy 1 is processed last, policy 2 wins. The policy setting applied is prohibit access to the control panel disabled. Let's take a look at this in action. We're now back in group policy management, and here are our two GPOs, our ittaster user GPO and our help desk users GPO. Now we can easily change the order in which these GPOs are processed by simply clicking on the GPO and moving it up or down in the link order using the arrows. Now if you remember, our ittaster user GPO is configured to prevent users from accessing the control panel, whereas the help desk users GPO is configured to allow users to access the control panel. We know that the ittaster user GPO has the highest priority in the link order and therefore it will be processed last, which means our users will be prevented from accessing the control panel. However, I'm going to enforce the help desk users GPO to allow the users to access the control panel. To enforce a GPO, simply right click on the GPO, click enforced, click OK to confirm. The GPO now shows as enforced, so let's log on to a client workstation and see the result. If we click start, you'll notice our control panel is back and we can open it. And this is because the help desk GPO is now enforced and it's allowing us access to the control panel. Now if we click on Internet Explorer, you'll notice it goes to the default homepage we configured. And if we go to Tools, Internet Options, Connections and LAN Settings, there's our proxy server that we specified, and we're also prevented from changing any of the settings. But if you remember, these are the policy settings that we configured in our ittaster users GPO. I didn't configure any internet settings for our help desk GPO at all. In fact, I enforced the help desk policy. But because I didn't configure any policy settings for Internet Explorer, they would remain as not configured, and they would be enforced as not configured. So when our ittaster user group policy object is processed, our Internet Explorer settings can then be applied. So remember, you can only enforce a configured policy setting. The next thing I want to move on to is inheritance. Inheritance is pretty straightforward. By default, child organizational units inherit the GPOs that are linked to the parent organizational unit. However, we do have the option to block inheritance. I've created a child OU within the ittaster users organizational unit, and I've called it ittaster supervisors. At the moment, any objects placed inside the ittaster supervisor's child organizational unit will inherit all of the GPO settings that have been linked to the parent OU, the ittaster user's organizational unit. There are situations where you might not want to do this, and that's where we have the option to block inheritance. To block inheritance, you need to be in group policy management, right-click the child organizational unit, choose block inheritance. A symbol appears to show you that inheritance is blocked, and that's all there is to it. To link an existing GPO to our child organizational unit, we simply need to right click the organizational unit, choose link an existing GPO. I'm going to choose help desk users and click OK. You can also remove a link to a GPO by right-clicking the GPO link in the organizational unit and choosing delete. Now bear in mind this will not delete the GPO itself, it will only remove the link. And click OK. To delete a GPO, you need to go into Group Policy Objects. You need to right-click the GPO, choose Delete, and confirm that you want to delete the GPO and all links to it. Before I go, I'm going to leave you with one useful command to help you with your group policy troubleshooting, and that's GP Update. Group policies are refreshed every 90 minutes by default, but you can force an update using the GP Update command. If you type gpupdate/force, this will update settings whether there have been any changes or not. Well, I hope this video has been helpful and it's given you a good starting point with group policy. Please subscribe to the ittaster channel, and thanks very much for watching.